Three, two.
Hello. Hello. Okay.
Alrighty, we're
This is
live and recording.
all right. So.
And yeah, you can give me a countdown whenever you like.
Okay.
Or
So this is Halo. It's on easy difficulty. And yeah, we can count down. The countdown's a little weird. Like the timer will start when I just say go, I guess.
yeah, just call start or go.
Right. Cool. Three, two, one, and
I gave you a
all
double
right,
dose of
like I said,
data.
this is Halo
Taking
Combat
measurements of
Evolved
ground
for the
combat
home
and
personal
optical
computer.
diagnostic stations in your
The easy
vicinity.
difficulty has a minute and 40 tutorial, so we're gonna have to go through this little light tutorial here.
I
And
need
I'm
more
playing
info on each
inverted,
of
so
the
I can skip an
possible
extra
targeting sensors.
lights
Notice,
tutorial.
just look at each of the
So that's
flashing
pretty
patterns
much
of
what's going on
target.
in the beginning of
Hit
this
lock on,
speedrun.
it'll change color.
The inverted
Okay,
controls are
good.
really awkward to
Array
control, so.
orbital.
Okay. Made it through the
Out.
hardest trick in the game,
Calling you from
menuing.
the shield test station.
The inverted controls are really awkward to control,
Apollo,
so I
approaching
play
Pentagon.
in non-inverted.
Alpha through Sierra.
And I
Sensors
pretty much just
detect a
play
heavy boarding craft.
inverted to
Stand
skip
by
like
for
an
airdrop
extra
orders.
10 to 15 second lights tutorial. Because the game asks you if you want to
Counter
play
UAV
inverted or
radio network
non-inverted.
awaits.
And yeah, pretty much basic tutorial stuff. They're testing my shields.
All right. Shields read
Read
as
at
fully
fully
charged.
charged.
Another way to speed
Communications
this
incoming down to test the
tutorial
operational
area
temperature.
up is this guy has to die pretty quickly. So I'm gonna do a nice little setup and let's hope we get good Sam death RNG.
Recharging normally. We're showing green across the board.
What's up, everyone?
Bridge to Cryo 2, this is Captain Key. Send the Master
Master
Chief
Chief
to
to
the
the
bridge
bridge
immediately.
immediately. Captain, we'll have to skip the weapons diagnostics and
On the
IR.
double, Truman.
Oh.
Aye, aye, sir.
Okay.
The skipper seems
All right.
crazy. We'd better get
Let's
moving. We'll
listen for
talk about
Sam.
this later.
Okay, I'll leave
I'll
the
leave the
self-diagnostics
self-diagnostics
running
running
at
at
least.
least.
Oh God,
Oh God,
they're trying to get through the door. Security!
Security!
Intruders
Intruders
in
in Cryo
2,
2,
please
please
don't!
Sam!
Oh, hell yeah.
Come on,
Good
we gotta get the
RNG.
hell out of
Didn't even
here.
hear him scream. I gotta jump over these pipes. And now we're on our way to a speedy speed run.
Secure those blast doors! Move! Move! Covering fire! Whoa! Found him!
Nothing much
Recon
going
team
on
on
in
the
the
bridge
first level.
ASAP! Better follow me!
It's mostly just optimized movement. I gotta
Stay back!
dodge a bunch of these Marines, otherwise they'll slow me down. Right here, I can enter the bridge, which is where we're going to, and just back out, and it'll start the cutscene.
I don't
Then I just
think
skip
that's
the
going
cutscene.
to work.
What's up, clowns? AIT, thanks. Normally, keys gives you a pistol here in the beginning, but if you can walk out fast enough, you'll skip the pistol, and
Those
you'll
Marines
skip
could use some help, Chief.
three
Do what you
grunts
do
that would
best.
normally spawn there, and you'd have to kill. And then that door opens, and you just pick up this assault rifle. That saves a bit of time. Yeah, didn't even hear him scream. That was really good. There isn't really much going on in the easy difficulty for Pillar of Autumn. I will be getting some grenades at the end, that are like the first grenades in the run, I guess. They don't really let you use grenades yet until the very end of this level. So I'm pretty much just going to be using this AR to mow down grunts and get to the end of the level. But after this, the run should pick up. I even like shoot some of these Marines to get them out of the way. I'm gonna pick up this pistol here. The pistol is actually a really, really good weapon. Can take down grunts in one headshot, and it's just completely overpowered in
Covenant,
general.
on the landing above us.
Do some six stair jump strats here to avoid going all the way around. That's weird, they were aware of my presence. So were these grunts.
Combat teams on deck 7 and 8, all hands. This
pistol also has a scope.
Prepare to abandon ship. Combat team. Orders until ops personnel are away. Good luck. He's out.
The life pods are launching. We should hurry. Warning. Blast doors closing. We have to use the ship.
I guess I could mention it now. In a bit.
The Covenant are destroying.
You're going to be seeing a lot of these. There are these little tutorial pop-ups. They're going to be popping up for like entering vehicles and stuff. Since we're playing on the easiest difficulty, there's going to be a lot of tutorial messages, and I'll just be skipping through those. This next tutorial message coming up is for bashing this door, but since we did it so fast, it's going to pop up a little later. And when tutorial messages pop up, Master Chief just seizes up and can't move anymore, and you have to like start walking again. But if I jump and then skip the tutorial,
it looks like the Covenant
I won't like stop moving. So that's a tiny optimization where I can just keep going. Because let's say if I pause the game right now, I'll just like freeze and have to repress W, and it's just really slow. Here's the grenades I was talking about. Alright, cool. And that's Pillar of Autumn.
Chief, can you hear me? At last.
Now we're on the second level of the run, Halo.
Yeah, there's the impact. There's nothing we can do.
We're gonna see our very first grenade jump on this level.
Warning. I've detected multiple Covenant dropships on approach. I recommend moving into those hills.
And our very first rock jump as well.
The Covenant will believe that everyone aboard this lifeboat died in a crash.
That was dumb. My first frag just bounced off. Rip frag. Anyway, I haven't mentioned it yet, but throughout the entire speedrun, I'm going to be using a reloading technique called backpack reloading, and pretty much I can reload my weapon while I have my secondary pulled out, so you can do that with both weapons by just double tapping the reload key and switching the weapon quickly, and I can have both of my weapons reloaded like all the time. So there's like no slowdown for combat.
I'm reading a life.
And the only excuse is like just being bad, I guess. Survivors. There's no horse tilting in this game, Xeno, sadly. So there's 5 dropships in this area that I have to take care of. I'm gonna try to skip one of them by taking care of the first 4 really quickly. So hopefully I can do that. Right now I want to save these Marines. Oh, I didn't get the dialogue skip. It wasn't fast enough. So the theme of this level is going to be saving all of the Marines. Because we just crash landed in Halo. So this is one of the 5 dropships. This one doesn't really matter, it's on a timer. Kind of, but this one does. If I can't clear this one fast enough, then I won't be able to skip the 4th dropship. So a couple of well-placed grenades, and I can... Nice, that was perfect. Pretty hard to die in this game on easy, but it can happen in the later levels. So after this dropship, we'll find out if we got the drop skip. Ooh, that's bad. Ooh, that's really iffy. We might have gotten it. Yeah, got it. Easy trick. So that trick, well, this trick I just got, normally there's a dropship that spawns over there, but since we took care of the first three really quickly, we don't have to do the fourth one. That last clear was slow.
This is Pelican Echo 419. Anybody reading me? Repeat. Any UNSC personnel respond.
So that trick saves about like 25 to 30 seconds. It's pretty good that I got it. Glad I got to show that off. This guy can give me frags. Nope. Dang, two frags. That's not a lot.
Look, more lifeboats
for the first area.
If those lifeboats make it
so you can technically skip this area, but it wouldn't be faster because there's a lot of walking in this level, or there's huge distances to cover, so we just pretty much just do this first area to get this Warthog, or the Halo car, sorry. So we're gonna use the Halo car to
a natural formation.
Navigate this built entire mission.
So it must lead somewhere.
The Halo car is pretty cool. We can do this thing called flings. You can actually fling out of the car at very high speeds.
We should show them who they're dealing with.
We'll be using that to get
Master
to.
Chief, I'm going to use your suit's transcom system to monitor
places.
Their chatter.
The Halo car is also really hard to control, or. It's very special. It's very slippery. Like, it doesn't act like a normal car. It's just... it's like you're driving on ice physics. So, let's see if I can get this first fling. Oh, barely got it. It's fine, though. You can just use the car to get on top. But yeah, pretty much I flung myself to that, little lip there, and it was gonna launch me up. And pushing that button activates the light bridge to get across. And if the enemies are aware of my presence, I can skip the light bridge cutscene. Normally, when you push that button, there's a 15-minute cutscene that plays. So as long as they know
there's
I'm around or I'm in combat. Should
a
skip the cutscene.
Crew made it off the autumn than I had predicted.
And I'll be using that
the captain really
exploit like twice in the run.
If we can find Captain Keyes and the other survivors, we have a chance to
I think it's just
an
twice.
Effective resistance.
Yeah, we don't need friction where we're going. So now pretty much my goal is to save or go to three different areas to save Marines, and I'm gonna save them. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna save them. But I can't like murder the Marines because that would be bad. They'll get mad at me, and the mission might softlock and stuff. So I'm not gonna kill the Marines. I'm gonna let them run into accidents, so it makes it look like I didn't kill them. And hopefully, if I can accidentally kill them
let's check it out.
Enough times with like grenades, the level will still be pretty fast. I missed that fling. You can fling to this door, but
we
that's fine.
The interior of those structures before we leave.
So here's the first few Marines. Let's see if we could save them.
I've called for an evac.
Okay.
Didn't rescue any of the Marines. 100% casualties.
Dang, we didn't save them. Alright, now we're out of here to the next area. But yeah, running them over with a Warthog counts as an accident, and killing them with grenades counts as an accident, so I don't want
to
softlock the mission, so I'm just gonna throw these grenades and hopefully get rid of all of them. And I guess you could save the Marines, but it's very slow saving the Marines. You have to kill waves of flood not fled, kill waves of Covenant and
survivors detected. Marines are concealed.
Wait for a dropship to come pick them up. And you'd have to do that for three different areas, and that would lose like at least 3 minutes each, or 3 minutes for like all the marine areas. Is that all of them? Wow, that was bad. Despite having good spawns, that's pretty bad. I hope I got rid of all of them. Yeah. I hope I got all of them. They're mad at me now, but it shouldn't matter for this area. I've been able to finish this mission before with them being mad at me.
What are you doing? We have to stay with the Marines. We need to find the
I'm gonna wait here to get the good dialogue. If you're fast enough, you could just keep driving, but I wasn't fast enough.
There are some Marines hiding in the hills above the structure.
Get out of here! Pull it back!
Oh, you're a sight for sore eyes.
Alright. I want the Marines to say you're a sight for sore eyes.
I'll call in a dropship to pick them up.
And that's when Cortana will call in the dropship.
The Covenant has located and secured the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. The good news is the captain is still alive. The bad news is that the Covenant have captured the entire surviving command crew. Let's hurry and find the final lifeboat so we can link up with the rest of the survivors.
Okay, so this is the last area. And the Marines weren't mad at me, so that's good. Usually it carries on to the next area, so it still finishes mission pretty fast. That's the last of them?
That's the last of them.
Nice.
Roger that. I'm on my way.
Alright, that was a pretty okay Halo.
New traffic on the Covenant battlenet. I found Captain Keyes. He's being held on a Covenant cruiser.
Play some golf.
The Truth and Reconciliation, a ship I disabled before we abandoned the Autumn.
Dang.
The Truth and Reconciliation touched down on a desert plateau roughly 300 kilometers upspin.
And that's the end of the
There's
second
our ride.
Level.
Get aboard and let's get out of here.
Welcome aboard, Ma- The enemy has captured Captain Keyes.
Alright, on to the third level. This is Truth and Reconciliation.
Truth and Reconciliation. The ship is currently holding position approximately 300
So we saved the Marines, but Captain Keyes got captured. So now we're gonna go save Captain Keyes.
Or issued me a rifle, not wings. There's a gravity lift that ferries troops and supplies between the ship and the surface.
This mission has a lot of
Once we get inside
wave
the ship,
fights.
I should be able to lock on to the tracking signal from Captain Key's neural implants.
Hit him, Marines.
So
go,
we're gonna
go,
have to
go,
try to
go,
deal
go,
with those as fast as we
Stick
can.
To the higher ground to the right. We should be able to recon the Covenant position.
This beginning area, you're supposed to do it like stealth, but just gonna non do that because it's slow, and we can just run all the way to the end. And killing the enemies here doesn't really matter. I'm just mowing them out of the way because they can block you. So really, I'm just trying to get to the big ship in the sky. There's a grav lift that I have to get to.
Covenant forces detected up ahead. The path up on the left should let us sneak up around them.
Funny thing about this level, it gives you an absurd amount of sniper rifle ammo. Like, I think you have 64 bullets in the beginning.
Cortana to fire team Charlie. Move up on
when you're
left.
Only supposed to be able
to
carry,
able to
like, less than 30, somewhere around there. So, they really wanted you to use the sniper for this level. To, like, strategically snipe all of the enemies in the area. Dang. This guy. To kill a specific amount of Covenant.
Alert! Covenant
there we go.
Ships are inbound.
Man, it's always so
I want that alert dialogue. That means that this dropship will come in and then we can start the wave fights. Oh. One grunt was left alive.
Yeah.
plasma nades are like the weakest. Should be all of them. That was a little sloppy, but we got through it. Wow, look at this guy. Okay, that was slow. But could have been faster. We've secured the area. Let's square away the grab lift. I want to pick up a plasma pistol before I get into the ship.
Once we're inside the ship.
The plasma pistol is actually really useful with killing enemies fast. In this game, it's going to be like our main weapon if we want to deal with Covenant.
I've got a good lock on the captain's CNI transponder.
Where he at? There he is. I kill a Marine there to skip his line of dialogue, and the wave fights start immediately. There's like six random waves in the ship that I have to deal with before I can progress. So that's two. I like to use my frags for these little rooms here because it takes care of them a lot quicker. And I also want to constantly be shooting my plasma pistol because it alerts the enemies and they walk out of the doors faster. There's like three set spawns, or three different types of waves you can get. You can get four grunts, one elite and two jackals, one elite and two grunts. One elite and two grunts is the best you can get, because elites are really easy to kill, and so are grunts, so those are the optimal ones you want. Alright, now that we're out of that room, the Marines want me to open the door to the next to this area, but instead of doing that,
that's the locked door,
I'm gonna find an elite. The Marines are waiting on the other side. I'm gonna overcharge him so he gets angry at me, and then he's gonna come to this door and open it for me. These red doors can only be opened by Covenant, so that's one way to get past unlocked doors on this level. There's also a weird thing with the AI. If you can kill an elite around like grunts and
Cortana to Echo 419,
jackals, they'll just scatter. So you can use that to your advantage as well. This is the TNR nade stack I'm about to do. I'm gonna place three grenades. Jump. Picking up the overshield gives you invincibility for a little bit while it's charging up, so that's how I'm able to do that three nade stack without dying. And the last two nades take a lot of my health, so like the first nade just like, or the second nade just took out all my shields, and that last frag took out most of my health, so that's how we're able to do that. It just works out. Should be all of them. Yep. Okay, now I'm just making my way to Captain Keyes. There's another thing that nade stack did that I'll mention after I rescue Keyes. It kind of breaks the level in a way. And you don't really have to kill these enemies that I'm killing right now, but it's going to make going back a lot easier because I have to make my way back after I save Keyes.
Back to the shuttle bay and call for evac.
I'm gonna try doing this area without health. I killed two Marines there to get Captain Keyes angry at me and the rest of the Marines. I can very easily die here. Oh, don't die. Okay, we're still good. Because now the Covenant want to kill me as well as Captain Keyes, so I think we're in the clear. I don't think we'll die. Okay. Angering the Marines gets Captain Keyes in to follow me to the end of the level a lot quicker. Plus, it's going to skip 40 seconds of extra dialogue. Because I did the nade stack in the beginning, it breaks a lot of the triggers, and a lot of the enemies don't spawn, so as soon as I get to this bridge, the level's going to end. So we don't have to get a ship to escape the big dropship or the Truth and Reconciliation thing we're in, and that saves a bunch of time, as well as the 40 seconds of dialogue.
The island has multiple structures.
Alright, now we're in the fourth level, Silent Cartographer. I'm actually on PB pace right now. This has been going really well. I'm only like 2 seconds behind my PB. Alright, so this is Silent Cartographer. Starts with a nice long walk on the beach. This is probably the most broken levels because you only need to hit one like trigger and then you can get all the way back to the end. So you can just, you know, get to the end and then make your way out. And how we'll be doing that is pretty neat. So right now I'm going in the opposite direction the Marines want me to go to get a Warthog or Halo car. And I'll be doing a trick called the Stick Stack. This is probably the second shortest mission in the game.
Looks like there is
this is the second shortest mission in the game.
Island.
And you'll see why very soon. So we start by getting this Halo car. And this is the building where the Silent Cartographer is, which is a Halo's map or something.
I'll bet the
it's important in the story or something. So normally you're not supposed to drive this Warthog down here.
The cartographer must be here. Don't let them lock the doors.
And this doorway is gonna lock. But if I can drive the hog and turn my camera, there you go. You can just make your way in. I'm gonna pick up two plasmas there. I'm shooting my assault rifle there to skip a cutscene. When I'm in combat, the cutscene won't play. I'm gonna jump here. Crouch before I fall, so I negate, or crouch before I land, so I negate most of the fall damage. Now we'll try to get Stick Stack. Stick Stack is a pretty interesting trick. Wait for a checkpoint. In case I mess it up. So I'm gonna be throwing six well-placed grenades. And then sticking myself. And then jump. We didn't get it. Shame. If they all blow up at once, and you're standing in just the right spot, you can get thrown all the way back to the top of the level and just end it from there. But instead we landed on the second floor. So I'll take that. I don't really want to try it two times. It would waste time if I did. Oh shit, I might die. Go wait for my shields to recharge. There you go.
Understood.
That was really scary. I almost lost all my shields then.
Here are your orders. I want you to use any means necessary to force your way into the facility and find Halo's control center. We have to get to the center before the...
This is still pretty fast. This breaks even with the normal route you would usually take. So it's just as fast. So going for it doesn't really lose time. Getting it saves about 25 seconds. It would save maybe 20 since I waited for the checkpoint. Alright, we're good. It's a shame I didn't get it. It's a really cool trick when you get it. The current world record for Halo has the Stick Stack, and it looks really nice. And that's the end of this level. On to level 5, Assault on the Control Room. So we're halfway through the run at the end of this level. There's five more missions after this. This mission's pretty broken as well. I'm going to be doing a trick called the bridge fall. And doing the bridge fall is going to break the entire level. And I'll be getting like no enemy spawns. You'll see. So this is a pretty lengthy level if you just go through it normally. Like, it's probably one of my favorite levels when I was playing this as a kid. It's got like tanks and stuff. Really cool mission, but we won't be seeing that. Before you do the bridge fall, quick magic trick. Disappear.
Interesting.
So this is the bridge fall.
They seem natural, not artificial. I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning. Or if
I'm going to be doing three very precise falls.
This is Fire Team Zuna requesting immediate assistance.
Second fall is the hardest. Just got past that one. Third fall can be...
There are any human forces left on this.
It's pretty easy, but I can still mess it up.
I read you. Fire Team Zulu, this is Cortana. Hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that. Make it quick.
And Master Chief has a fall timer, so I land on these little slopes. Oh, I died. That's a shame. Yeah, third fall can be deceptively difficult sometimes.
I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning.
But as I was saying, Master Chief has a fall timer. If I'm falling in the air for a like long amount of time, I'll just die outright. That only loses like 20 seconds.
Left on this part of the ring.
Cortana to Fire Team
Let's
Zulu.
Not mess it up this time.
Fire Team Zulu, this is Cortana. Hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that.
Damn, I took a lot of health damage from that. There we go. That's how that's supposed to go. So I just land on a few slopes and then just slide off to abuse the fall timer. And there's supposed to be like a huge fight here, but since I skipped all of the triggers, we're going to get no enemies this entire level, and we're just going to be doing a bunch of ghost driving to the end. Nice little MOA spam. Lilimo is probably my favorite out of all the MOAs. Oh. Got a nice little ghost sling there. That was slow because, well, I wasn't supposed to get flung that far, but we still good. We can do a swag strat here. Oh! Just made it. Optimizing the ghost driving in this level is pretty difficult. You can lose a lot of time with just bad ghost driving. This level is usually like around 6 minutes and 10 seconds long if you're good, but I'm not, so I waste like 8 seconds, 10 seconds to just bad ghost driving. Yeah, most of the emotes being spammed were made by a bunch of 5th graders. I work at a school and I just took a picture of all their emojis that they made on like little paper plates. And yeah, they're pretty great. Some of them look pretty terrifying, but they're artists in the making, in my opinion. Anyway, nothing much to this level, just a lot of driving. Gonna get in this Banshee. Normally you're not able to get into this Banshee because the Elite spawns and just gets in and attacks you. But the Elite never spawns, so I could just steal his ride. Ooh. Oh, more magic. Oh. How does he do it? I don't know. Can do a nice little grenade jump here. Saves about like 5 seconds of extra walking. Dang. No, I didn't make the MOAs. A bunch of fifth graders at the school I work at made all the MOAs. Some of my friends just like cropped them in paint and made them into FFZ emotes. They're pretty great. Alright, last magic trick. Don't close your eyes. Don't blink. Oh, where did it go? Alright, come to the end of the level. I just gotta push a few buttons here to open these last like 4 doors, and then we're out of here. It's faster to drive through these doors with the Banshee. Now, I don't want to die. This Banshee could actually splatter you. If I die, I'm going to be taken all the way back to the ghost section, so I'm going to play these pretty safe. This is probably the most punishing checkpoint. Since we broke a bunch of triggers, we're not going to get checkpoints for the entire level. Okay, we didn't die. Good. Nice joke, Hecky. Nice depression joke, friend. Alright. This is the 6th level out of 10. 343 Guilty Spark.
Captain's dropship was from this area. That was over 12 hours ago.
This level's pretty cool. It has a ton of little tricks. So just like really tiny optimizations strung together. So Captain Keys is in trouble again. He just disappeared. So we're gonna save his ass one more time. So we're going to go find out what happened. This level introduces a new enemy type called the Flood. They're pretty much a zombie kind of things, and they're pretty bad. So we have to go down a few floors. I can actually get off this elevator early in. Slide off these slopes. So right now I'm making my way to the reveal room where the Flood are first shown. And I want these doors to be open, so I'm going to shoot this guy closer to the door. Dang. If you can get him closer to the door, he'll open it for you. Nice little grenade jump here to get to the top of this. And we're at the reveal room. The first Flood is going to be shown our popcorn Flood. You'll see what I mean when you see them. It's going to be 3 doors opening. I want to take care of them pretty quickly, so I'm just going to throw nades. And the music started, so that means that they're the minimum that I needed to kill are killed off, and I could just exit now. So that was a pretty good reveal room. Ah. So since we're out of the, or since we got to the reveal room, we just got to get out of here now. Oh, grenade jump. This saves very little time, but it's cool. I think this is the first time we see the shotgun in the game. The shotgun is the best against Flood. It just takes them down in like one shot. The spread is random though, so it might take two shots sometimes, but if you can get them like dead on, it's one shot. Shotgun's pretty OP. Coming up is the hardest trick in the run, camo jump. Or as the community calls it, camo jumo. It's called camo jump because we pick up this active camouflage. Then we jump! Nice. That's a very tight jump. And yeah, once you get there, you can just skip that room entirely. Oh man, it's a Star Moa raid. Get a grenade jump here. Now I'm at one red, so thankfully I have this camo to hide me from the flood. Otherwise I would have died in one shot. Because I have no shields and I'm at one red. Oh, magic trick. I just walked on air for a bit. Alright, cool. And that's pretty much the end of this level. The end of this level is pretty interesting. The level won't end until you kill a set amount of flood, or if you kill the sentinels. There's a few triggers that end this level essentially. Once I get to the end, there's gonna be a bunch of flood and sentinels. Sentinels are these robot things that shoot lasers. But if I'm at one red, that's another trigger as well. So I use that frag jump to get myself to one red, so the level will end early. I guess the developers thought like the flood are like getting too much for him, we should just end the level. Kind of like it's your final fight or something. So just gotta find a way to get yourself conveniently at one red health, and the level should end once we get to this area. So I'm just gonna hide away and wait for the level to end. Nice. Alright, now we're on the best level, the library. This is one of the longer levels. It's like 13 minutes if you're good, 14 I guess. It's a pretty lengthy level. There's 10 doors that we have to wait for to open, or 10 doors that we'll have to get through. We can clip through 5 of them using the flood. In Halo, there are two types of flood. There are just regular old flood that will die if you kill them. And there's revivers. If I can take a flood down with one shot of this, he's a reviver. So that's not a reviver. That took two shots to kill. And I could use the revivers to clip through doors, because when they die, their collision is gone for a bit. But it reappears once they come back to life, just like that. That was a reviver. You can clip through this door, but it doesn't save that much time. So I'll just wait for it to open. Alright, cool. But there are a few doors that we definitely want to clip through, because they take just way too long for them to open. Yo, what's up, Bing? Thanks. So pretty much I'm going to do a pretty specific lineup, shoot a flood so they go down, stand on top of him, and then clip through the door as soon as he revives. And that's how flood bumping works. The first door only saves like 10 to 15 seconds, it's not really that useful. It's not a lot of time in a 13 minute level. So this is just going to be a lot of walking through gray hallways and getting through doors. Oh, I haven't mentioned one thing as well. The The revivers are completely RNG. Like, you don't really know if you'll get a reviver for each door. And sometimes you'll just have to wait. You can tell if they're a reviver by just shooting like your pistol shot at them this once and they'll die, but yeah, you pretty much like only get one shot or two shots at some of the doors. I'm gonna do grenade jump here to skip a trigger, to skip three sentinel spawns.
Flood activity has caused a failure in a drone control subsystem. I must reset the backup unit. Please continue.
So this is the second door, or two of the five doors we have to clip through, or we can clip through. I'm gonna set myself up. I'm gonna wait for a human flood. Human floods are the easiest to bump with. Nope, not a reviver. What a guy. Oh, come on. That could have been a reviver. Am I gonna get no revivers for this door? Oh, there's another one. Come on, do it. Oh well, I'll just wait for the door to open. Yeah, door's opening. I want to be at full health for this door, or after this door, because I have to do a grenade jump, a frag grenade jump, and that's going to take me to one red. So I need all the health I can get. I can do a plasma nade jump since I have plasma nades, but they're a little awkward to time. But they're definitely possible. So I didn't get that bump. That would have saved like 30 seconds maybe. But it's fine. You can still get like a 14 minute library without bumps.
Please wait here.
There are a few doors that are that will guarantee like get us bumps though. We'll see. Because we set them up in a very specific way. So three more doors to go through. I think there are like 10 doors in total. Some of them we grenade jump through. This is the rocket hallway. Nice. Got good luck. There's some rocket flood here. I don't think I mentioned rocket flood yet. They're pretty much just flood with rocket launchers. They can one-hit kill you, even on easy. No, the grenades actually work a little different on the hardest difficulty. You can do a lot more grenade jumps on legendary. Plasma nade jumps only take down your shields, but on easy, they take down your shields and your health. It's pretty interesting. For whatever reason, the grenades do a lot more damage on easy. I guess it's to kill the flood easier, I'm not sure. Or just kill the enemies easier in general. I'm not too sure. But you can do a lot more grenade jumps on legendary.
I would conjecture that the other species currently on the installation is responsible for releasing the
flood. I think that's like one of the cooler things about the legendary speedrun for Halo. Is more grenade jumps. Otherwise it would just be a run with like more enemies and you can die easier, but I'm glad like you can do more nade jumps on legendary. It makes the run a lot more interesting in my opinion. I'm gonna delay a checkpoint here using a plasma nade. I'm gonna throw this plasma nade, and when it blows up, I'll get the checkpoint. Nice. And that delays it a bit, so I'm closer to this door. Getting that checkpoint is pretty useful because I can revert if I don't get a reviver. There you go. Second try, that's good. I'll be doing that with the next door coming up. Nice. Rocket flood. XD. That door is called the Dark Door because it's dark. Coming up is the 69 door. Because it takes like 60 seconds to open. On easy. Is this PB pace? Kind of. I'm only like 39 seconds behind PB at the moment. I'm going to fire my shotgun here to get the flood to follow me. I want to kill these carriers because they get in the way. So I'm just shooting my shotgun so they follow me. And I got a huge amount of flood following me. We're going to do the same thing as we did with Dark Door here. We're going to look for revivers. Not a reviver. Not a reviver. Reviver. Okay, shotgun. It's the shotgun dude. Alright, he's following me. We in there. So this is one way to get a consistent flood bump, by getting a checkpoint, because if you can make a checkpoint or flood spawn consistently, I'm going to try getting a teleport here. It's a pretty cool trick. Pretty much how teleports work, you just get wedged into some geometry and it teleports you for whatever reason. But yeah, that's one way to get consistent flood bumps, just make a checkpoint with flood already spawned so they can't randomly change. They'll always be revivers, and they always won't be revivers, you know. Except with Dark Door. Dark Door, they spawn each time. But the 69 Door, they're always consistently there. They don't disappear with each checkpoint or change their reviver status. Alright, one more door and, well, two more doors technically, but one more door to bump through, or that you can bump through, and we're coming to the end of library. Pretty boring, I know, but to be fair, this has been a pretty good library. It's not been the worst. I want to get a human flood. Nice, we got one. Alright, come here, buddy. Hey, look at that luck. Cool. Yeah, the IL is pretty funny. The world record holder got his, the IL world record in a PB attempt. And he saved a lot of time. He got all five bumps and yeah, it was really well played, and he just got the IL. Hopefully I get the checkpoint. Yes. I killed those carriers to get this checkpoint here. You can actually die while going through that door. That flood jumping through can just have a shotgun and shoot you, and you're at one red once you do a frag jump, so you're just gonna die. Also, there's a lot of enemies behind me. There they are. Sorry.
The energy barrier surrounding the index will deactivate when we reach the ground floor.
Now we get a minute-long cutscene. So if you have any donations, you can read them out now. Just kidding.
You may now retrieve the index.
That's a bad joke, I'm sorry.
Protocol requires that I take possession of the index for transport. Your organic form renders you vulnerable to infection. The index must not fall into the hands of the Flood before we reach the control room and activate the installation. The Flood is spreading. We must hurry.
Look out.
All right, now we're on the... Which level are we on? Eighth level? Yeah. Two betrayals. This is another long level, but for different reasons. This level is pretty awful in terms of like speedrun routing and stuff, because there are going to be a lot of triggers we have to hit. It's about like 10 to 11 minutes long. It's going to be pretty much just going through the level normally, with a few sections that we can do fast.
We can't let the monitor activate Halo.
Still pretty interesting, but
we have to destroy
it's
Halo.
Very good and very bad. Very bad that we can't do a lot of skips, because there are some pretty neat skips we could do if there weren't so many triggers. And it's also pretty bad because I can die very easily in this level, even on the easiest difficulty.
A starship's fusion reactors going critical would do the job. I'm going to search what's left of the Covenant Battlenet and see if I can locate the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. If the ship's fusion reactors are still relatively
so there are a few reactors I have to hit.
Use them to destroy
pretty much
Halo.
The goal of this level. We're just gonna hit all the reactors.
I haven't located the crash site yet.
I think there's like three or four of them.
In case the monitor or
this is the first one.
Find a way to activate Halo's final weapon without the index. The machinery in these canyons are Halo's primary firing mechanisms. They consist of three phase pulse generators that amplify Halo's signal and allow it to fire deep into space. The power levels are enormous.
That's the pulse generator.
I can't even begin to calculate the pulse's
nice.
Range.
When you hit the reactors, it takes down your shields to like zero, so you can take a lot of damage very quickly. Because once we don't have our shields, we can just take all the health damage.
So, if we damage or destroy these generators, the monitor will need to repair them before Halo can be used.
And that generator is pretty easy because there are no enemies around, but there's going to be a few generators where there's a lot of enemies in the room, and we have zero shields, so it can be really risky.
And neutralize the device. Wait, we should commandeer one of those Banshees. We'll need it to reach the pulse generator in time.
Sick nade jump you can do to get up there, but takes down your shields to zero. It doesn't save that much time. So I just hit a trigger back there and it spawned these jackals. If these jackals didn't spawn, I already know I missed a trigger. So if enemies just like stop spawning, I know I missed a trigger somewhere by just going too fast through the level, so you gotta slow down sometimes. Yo, what's up, Dark Raider? Yeah, dude, the one and only. So this is the first bridge. The beginning of the level is pretty tame. It kind of shows you what you're going to go through. This first bridge is pretty easy. Nice. Second bridge is not as easy. I know, crazy, right? Slowing down in speedrun. So the first generator, the first bridge are pretty tame, but there are a few more generators and bridges we have to cross. I think there's one more bridge. There's a rocket flood here. Nice, he didn't shoot his rocket. I'm gonna pick that up because it's gonna be useful. You can get incredibly unlucky in that hallway and just die if the rocket hits you, like, right in the face. No checkpoint? No checkpoint. So this is second bridge. It's got a ton of rocket flood. There's a banshee that can just randomly swoop down and kill you. So we don't want to die on the second bridge. There's all the rocket flood I just killed. There's one more. Alright, we're good. We're not past it yet. There's still the banshee we have to worry about. Alright, we got a good banshee RNG. That was a really good second bridge. But yeah, you just, like, as you saw, there was like four rocket flood there that just could have killed me. And a banshee flying around. Alright. Now that we're done this top section, we're gonna start going down. There's actually a pretty cool elevator clip here I'm gonna go for. Hopefully I get it. Easy. That saves 2 seconds. I'm gonna flip this ghost here too.
Okay, let's take care of the next.
Come towards me. There we go. So there's like tiny things you could do to save time on this level. Nothing amazing. You still pretty much have to go through the level normally. You can pick up health and rockets here, but we don't need either. 4 health should be good enough for the next pulse generator. This pulse generator is named the Hell Room because there's a lot of flood. You're at 0 shields and you could just die randomly. There are a few rocket flood in this room as well, so if I die, don't be surprised. But dying doesn't really lose much time because we'll get a checkpoint hopefully. There we go. I'm gonna throw a frag to clear the area a bit. Hit the pulse generator and make our way out.
Pulse generator overloaded. One more to go.
Alright, cool. We still have enough rockets. Alright, we're out. Alive. Should kill this banshee here.
I located the Pillar of Autumn. She put down 1200 kilometers upspin.
Energy the banshees will follow me. Neat thing about the banshee physics, it's a lot faster to just fall down in the banshee rather than flying down. Like, it just drops like an anchor. It's pretty cool. So the physics on the banshee are a little weird, but that's a minor optimization there. Oh, whoa. Sick flip, dude. Okay. Alright, ghost, settle down. We almost died. As you can see. Alright, now we're gonna do the 100% strat. You can actually get your ghost through this door. The ghost actually takes no damage with rockets unless you're in the ghost itself, so you can just shoot rockets at it all you want and it won't blow up. That's not true with other Halos, though. Oh, did I miss the trigger? Did I actually miss it? There it is. There. There's 2 triggers there that you're supposed to hit, but because we're using a ghost, we're moving a lot faster than we would be moving on foot. I'd rather ride a ghost horse. Uh, There's another trigger here that I have to hit. This one's pretty interesting. I have to kill five flood. There we go. I'm gonna kill one or two here just to make sure I got them all. I think I got them all though. Ah, didn't get to kill any. Dang. Pretty sure I got all five though. Yeah, I got all five. If there's no enemies here, I didn't get all five, but you just saw enemies all over that area. Alright, now we just gotta fly this Banshee to the end and we're done this level. No ghost tilting, sadly, Zeno. Alright, now we're just flying to the last pulse generator and we're moving on to Keys. Now Keys is in trouble again, so we're gonna go get Keys one last time. I think he gets captured like at least three times in this game, he's so useless. I'm gonna pick up this health pack, because I can very easily die being at one red here. There's a few sentinels in this room. I don't want to die.
Final target neutralized. Let's get out of here.
I'm going to try for a strat here called the Keys Flood Bump.
Captain? Captain?
If I don't get it, I'll just restart the level. So I'm going to get this flood to follow me. And I'm going to bump through a door. It's like right here. Or bump through this wall, not really a door. Is that a reviver? Ah, dang. Oh well, I won't try for it again. If I got that, that would have been really good.
Captain? Captain?
I'll just do the normal strat now. You can actually bump through that wall and then just get to the end of the level. But we'll get to the end of the level a slightly different way. It's a pixel-perfect trick. It works similar to flood bumps. You just gotta line it up on a shield. I should be on the right pixel. So I'm just shooting this shield so it doesn't pop up on me. And then I'm gonna wait for it to pop back up and I'll get the bump. And this should take me straight out of bounds. And I could land here. And then I jump backwards because I can't see where I'm going. None of the level is loaded. Wow, really? That's so dumb. Garish did. So dumb. This platforming's not even hard. It's literally just jumping backwards. For some reason I hit something and I just fell off the world. Again? Okay, I'm doing something wrong here. Well, this is unfortunate. There we go. I don't know why I didn't get that the first two attempts. Damn, I got like the best luck this level and I squandered it. I could have PB'd with this run. Oh well. I hit a checkpoint there to spawn flood and the rest of the level to work. And then I just triggered this cutscene. And that's pretty much all I need to complete this level. I just gotta get to this area early.
No,
this is normally a pretty lengthy level, but It's just a shield bump and you run to the end. This is the shortest level in the speedrun.
You know what he'd expect. What he'd want us
and after
to
this
do.
Is the final level. The fractal. Thanks.
It's done. I have the code. We should go.
Alright, we out of here.
We need to get back to the Pillar of Autumn. Let's go back to the shuttle bay and find a ride.
Oh, don't die. Don't die. Are we good? Wow, go away. Stop shooting at me. Oh, one red. I've never been at one red here before. Oh no! Are you serious? No! Wow. This is a bad game. Don't speedrun this game. Now we have to watch the cutscene again! That loses like 2 minutes. You gonna do Maw Bump? Probably not. I'm pretty bad at Maw Bump. I don't have a setup.
No human life signs detected. The captain, he's one of them.
That was just really unlucky.
You know,
normally
what he'd expect.
Don't lose all your shields in that area.
What he'd want us to do.
And there was a shotgun flood that like took me down to like 3 yellow. And then this elite just kept shooting at me. And I had like no shields.
It's done. I have the code.
On that landing, so
we need to get
it was gonna happen.
Let's go back to the shuttle bay and find a ride.
Oh, now I take no damage. Look at that. Interesting. That was just unlucky. Look at that, full health, full shields. No damage taken. They die in 2 shots. Okay, that was really bad. I shouldn't be taking health damage there, or shield damage. Whatever. Can still sub 120, I think. Maybe?
Perfect.
Probably not.
Grab one of the escort banshees and we'll use it to return to the Pillar of Autumn.
Alright, final level of the run. Then we're done with Halo. This is the Maw.
We need to get to the bridge. From there,
probably looks familiar, it's the first level of the game, but just like really destroyed, because geez, crash landed. And we're pretty much going to blow up Halo, or destroy Halo, with this ship's reactor. Give me that shotgun. I can get a checkpoint. I might attempt Maw Bump. Nice. Alright, I'll attempt Maw Bump. Why not? I have a pretty bad setup, but I'll just do it once. But the platforming isn't too bad. Oh, oh well. Not gonna attempt it. Just lose 10 seconds. Maw Bump only saves 20 seconds if you're good at it. It's, getting out of bounds and doing some precise platforming on the ceiling to skip this bridge.
Let's get to work.
Where he at? There he is.
I need you to upload me into the control systems. The terminal is located next to the main view screen.
Oh, nice. Got a frame perfect cutscene skip there.
The ship was heavily damaged when it crashed. Head to the cryo chamber. We should be able to get to the engine room through there.
Luckily, I know what to do when that happens. You just reload the checkpoint and it'll play the cutscene and you can skip it. That was really weird. I've never had it there. I've had it in Pillar of Autumn, but definitely not here. Pillar of Autumn and Truth and Reconciliation. Get out of the way. frags do I have? Pick up these two frags. I'm gonna pick up this overshield so I can do a rocket jump. You'll see what that is in a sec. Pretty much just making my way to destroy four generators and then getting through the end of the level. Ooh, we could still do it. As long as I don't get shot anymore. Alright, I'll go for this once.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert! The monitor.
Dang. Not enough health or not enough shields. I took too much shield damage from the enemies, so I can't even
engine
go for
room
it.
Located. We're here.
Looks really cool when you get it, though. You can pretty much just rocket jump to the second
Alert.
Floor rather than
the
going
monitor has
up
disabled
here.
All command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactors.
Don't fall off! I fell off! Damn. I've never fallen off there before.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command
access.
Hey, Milk.
You still at work?
The countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion
I'm
reactors.
Saving the marathon for you by intentionally dying on some spots.
Halo. Don't worry, I have access
oh,
to all
I almost
of the
died again.
Schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through
Are
it.
We good?
First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core. Good! Step one complete! We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. We need a catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cells. Use an explosive. I recommend a grenade or rocket. If you run out of explosives, there is an
so
armory
I gotta just destroy these reactors pretty quickly.
Analyze.
Hopefully I got both of them. Nice, I got both of them.
Fusion reactor number one
right,
destabilizing. Use explosives on the other three reactors. That should be enough to trigger a wildcat explosion of the engines.
The reactors just take like at least one rocket or a grenade. What up?
Yeah, I don't know what pace you're on. How much time do you think you've got left?
About like 3 minutes left of driving.
Cortana to
okay,
Echo
I'll be standby then.
Alright, cool.
For time.
Roger, Cortana.
Yeah.
I read you 5
I'll let you know when time is
the
coming up.
Of Autumn's engines are going critical, Foehammer. Request immediate extraction. Approach the crash site and be ready to pick us up at
All right,
external
we're
access
on the last part of the level. We just gotta do some
signal.
Sick driving on the Halo car. To the end of the game.
Echo 419 to Cortana. Things are getting noisy.
The ending of this game is actually pretty cool. I really liked it when
negative.
I
we have a wildcat destabilization of the ship's fusion core. The engines must have sustained more damage than we thought.
We won't be taking a lot of the ramp.
We have 6 minutes before the fusion drives detonate.
High jump routes because they're incredibly slow and I don't know, some of them just don't work. So there's a cool under ramp there we can go and take a jump, but we're not gonna do that. Instead, we're just gonna drive through these pillars. Because it's faster. But look at this. Look at all this epic driving you can do at the end of this game. We're not doing any of it. Oh, let's not get dicked by sentinels. Alright, we're good. Driving through those sentinels can flip your Halo car randomly. A runner lost world record to those sentinels. It was pretty funny. You're literally on the last part of the level and you're just driving and bam, your car flips. And you lose 10 seconds. Damn, I wish I had pizza, Zeno. Sounds sick. more pillar driving. Oh, this one wasn't as pretty as the first one. I'm roaming as fast as I can.
Wait, stop.
Wait,
this is
stop.
Where Fauxhammer is coming to pick us up. Hold position here.
So, spoiler alert, Fauxhammer dies.
Cortana to Echo.
Echo 419.
She's dead.
She's gone. Calculating alternate escape route.
So, now she doesn't pick us up, so we just gotta drive to
Launch Bay 7.
His backup ship.
Now, we can make it.
Hey, Raiden. The run went pretty okay. Last two levels were pretty awful, though. I gotta practice keys. But this was pretty steady pace all the way through. I'm really happy with this run. Didn't even vroom. You want me to vroom make car sounds or something?
Chief, up ahead there's a gap in the trench. At top speed, we should be able to clear it.
There you go, Milk. Car sounds for you. The trick here called 360 swag. It's actually faster to do a 360 there. Otherwise, you can nosedive and flip your Halo car. So that wasn't just for style points. A lot of people seem to think that we do that strat just for fun, but it's actually faster. You can drive through these barrels. Just gotta wedge your hog through them. There you go. Alright, get ready on time. It's coming up as soon as I hit the end of this level, and time. Now is Halo Combat Evolved for the home personal computer.
In an hour and 21 minutes.
We're cutting it close.
Nice. 4 minutes underestimate.
Nice, dude. So yeah, Halo's a pretty cool guy.
Yeah, Halo's a pretty cool guy.
He kills aliens. Doesn't afraid of anything.
Yeah, kills aliens, kills zombies, drives cars. It's pretty good.
Alright, good stuff.
Yeah, I could just cut it here if you'd like.
We'll let it play out for a sec, I'll tell you when to cut. But
right,
yeah,
cool.
Be sure to follow this on me. Up next, looks like we got Banjo Kazoo.
Banjo Kazoo. Nice. Yeah, that's my run for this marathon. DGen Dash is pretty cool. You guys should keep watching.
Yeah, keep Shut watching. Go on the Twitter. Go on the Facebook. Go on your MySpace.
Definitely excited for that Family Feud run.
Oh yeah, dude. Family Feud's gonna be hype. Alright, we're gonna go to a short intermission. Be back in about 2 minutes with some Banjo guys.
Bye, stream.